Good morning, friends. Happy, happy Friday. It is about 6:25. My WW workshop will be opening up in about 5 minutes for weigh-in. So I wanted to hop on really quick, let you guys know how my week went, ask you how your week went. I'll go into my workshop and I'll be back with a recap as well as a weigh-in. So first, let's talk about my week. So it ended up being a fairly decent week. I am so incredibly proud of myself because guess what? I walked all 4 days that I committed to walking. And let me tell you, my body is feeling it. My calves are sore, the front, the back. My legs are sore because part of my walk is up quite a steep hill. But I did it, you guys. I walked all 4 days. I walked every morning at 5 a.m. I'm going to be inserting the clips of my walk at the end of the video. So definitely, definitely stay tuned for that. But I walked all 4 days. It was glorious. It was so nice in the morning. Peaceful. I never saw a single person. The only thing I saw roaming around were my neighborhood deer. So it was so nice. So nice. I am definitely going to continue with the 4 days of walking. I absolutely, positively loved every minute of it, even though I am sore as heck. And on top of that, with my walk every day, there were 2 days this week that I hit over 11,000 steps on the good old Fitbit. And that was because I walked in the morning and then, of course, was fairly active at work as well. So how awesome is that? So I'm very proud of myself for continuing to do what I said I was going to do, which is walking. So stay tuned at the end for some clips of that. Now my food. My food was overall pretty decent. Yesterday was a little bit rough only because I did a job fair. So I was fed lunch. I ended up having a vegetarian wrap, but I don't know what was on the wrap as far as sauce goes. Tasted kind of pesto-y maybe. And then of course the wrap is pretty high in points. I did have a couple of chips and then I had a very small, like very small brownie or whatever came in the prepped lunch. So that was a little bit of a challenge. But other than that, my week was pretty darn good. But I am sore as sore can be. And I have a feeling that could affect my weigh-in because your muscles do retain water when they're rebuilding themselves. But I don't know, I could be wrong. I could still hop on the scale and have a great weigh-in. So overall, I did have a really good week. I'm excited about my new exercise routine. Really excited. I want to hear how your guys' week went as well. And I'm going to hop into my workshop and I'll be back to share the recap and my weigh-in. Hey guys, I'm out of my WW workshop. It was awesome. So it was a topic that actually I've never really thought much about because I'm kind of still in the beginning stages of my weight loss journey. So I haven't really thought about this topic, and that is taking a break from weight loss. So this doesn't mean quitting WW or stop going to your workshops. This simply means taking a short break from your weight loss, going into maintenance mode, not going into weight gain mode. So I want to make that really clear. So of course I haven't thought much about this because I'm still in, definitely in the weight loss mode of my journey. But again, WW is a lifestyle. So there are times in our lives where things come down for us to do. There's events, there's weeks, there's months, there's days that can impact our journey. And when those things come about, it's okay to take a weight loss break. So I wanted to talk to you guys a little bit about what a weight loss break means exactly. So when you decide to take a break from your weight loss, that essentially means that you're going to put yourself into maintenance mode. You're still going to track, you're still going to watch the foods that you're eating, but you're going to go into maintenance rather than into losing mode. And there are times in our lives where this needs to happen. Things such as vacations, that's a huge one, where you're gone for days or a week or weeks on vacation. It's better to put yourself into maintenance mode than to put yourself into the mode of losing, where you feel this commitment to have to lose weight while you're on vacation, which can then lead you to not enjoy your vacation, or worse yet, leads you to binge or overeat. Birthdays, weddings, holidays, those types of things, it's okay to take a little bit of a break. It's okay to go into maintenance mode. It's okay to use your weeklies for the whole day or for the week, divide them up over the week. It's okay to go into maintenance. So what WW suggests, if you decide that you want to take a break, there's a few things that WW suggests that you do during that break. Because you're going to be taking a break, It's suggested that you set non-scale or NSV, non-scale victory, non-scale goals. So things as planning ahead for your meals, or if you're going on vacation, planning out your vacation a little bit. So these are the days I'm going to indulge. This is what I'm going to indulge with. This is what I'm going to bring to stay on track. So kind of plan it out. Plan out what you're planning to do non-scale related in order to be on maintenance. The next thing is set yourself some goals. So what is your goal? Is your goal to remain the same weight? Is your goal to indulge and not worry about what the scale says when you weigh in? What are your goals? And set your break from your weight loss around those particular goals. Also, make sure you're staying in touch. Go to your workshops. Stay in touch with your WW friends and buddies. If you have an accountability partner, stay in touch with that person. So that way it does help you stay on track as well, because you have someone that you're staying in touch with. You're still going to your meetings. You're reminding yourself every week or every day what your plan is, what your maintenance goal is, what's involved in your break. Next, honor your milestones. Did you maintain? When you go to your workshop and you hop on the scale, did you stay exactly the same? Or were you up just a tiny bit? Honor those milestones so that it keeps you motivated and it keeps you continuing to maintain and not to transition into gaining. That is the one thing we don't want to do when we take a break from our weight loss, is gain on the scale. We want to maintain, or better yet, see a loss on the scale. We just want to enjoy life, enjoy our vacation, enjoy our event, and not worry so much about our weight loss. This is a journey, not a race. It's okay to take a weight loss break. Lastly, continue to weigh yourself. If you do attend your workshop, weigh yourself there. If you are online or you don't attend a workshop because you're on some sort of a trip or you're out of town, continue to weigh yourself. And if you see the scale creeping up, put yourself into check. Do what you have to do to maintain, not gain. That is the biggest takeaway from taking a break from weight loss, is we're here to maintain, we're not here to gain. So if you start to see a little bit of a gain on the scale, that's when you have to maybe go back into weight loss mode or cut back your indulgences just a bit in order to maintain. So great ideas, great things to think about, not to work yourself up and stress yourself out over vacations or events. It's okay to take a break from your weight loss. So now let's talk about my week. As I told you guys in the beginning, I'm super, super duper proud of myself for exercising every day. Actually, you guys, I really enjoyed it. And I look forward to Monday, where I can get out in the morning before work and go on a walk. In fact, I am off Monday because of Memorial Day and Tuesday. So no excuses on those 2 days. I may even take a walk over the weekend, depending on the weather. I believe it's supposed to be a little bit rainy, so we'll just kind of see how the weather is. But I really enjoyed my exercise. Again, I'm sore. I know my body is sore because it's a new thing for me to be doing this regular exercise, but I loved it. My food was pretty good throughout the week, with the exception of yesterday. Now, I didn't go completely off the rails like crazy, but I did definitely go over my points yesterday. So when I stepped on the scale today, I lost 1 pound. I am happy to report that I lost 1 pound. Did I want to lose more? Of course, duh, who doesn't? But I am happy with the 1 pound loss. Extremely happy with that. So I'm hoping this next week to lose again, maybe a little bit more, so I can get kind of back to where I was before I had this crazy little bit of gain here and there. This month, you guys, has been rough. I don't know what the heck it is. I don't know what's going on with my body. I'm sure starting an exercise program was not beneficial for the scale, beneficial for my health, but not beneficial for the scale. So hopefully my body will start to adjust a little bit and I'll see that loss next week on the scale. So I'll take the 1 pound loss. I am definitely not complaining. How was your week? Did you guys gain? Did you lose? Was it what you expected when you hopped on the scale? I'd love when you guys leave me comments and let me know kind of how your week went. Let me know your thoughts on exercise, and if you've noticed a little bit of a slight gain, or maybe not the loss that you anticipated when you hopped on the scale with the start of an exercise program. Again, if you're new, thank you for coming over to my channel. Make sure that you subscribe. Hit that little notification bell so you're notified every single time that I upload. Give this one a thumbs up. Again, leave me some comments down below. I love reading your comments and engaging with you guys in the comment section of my video. Thank you so, so much for watching. Happy, happy Friday. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys. All right, guys, I'm out walking. It is 10 to 5 a.m. Literally, I just got up. That's why I don't even know what time it is. But I'm out and I'm a walk-in and I'm going to walk for about a half of an hour. I think that's about what this loop is that I have planned for today. I think it's about a half of an hour. So day one of walking at 5 a.m. It's actually really nice out. It's a little bit chilly. I want to say maybe in the 40s, high 40s, maybe low 50s. I'm not sure. It's a little chilly, but I've got on workout pants and a shirt. I'm not really too worried because exercising will definitely boost my heat in my body, so I should be just fine. So day one is a success. It's actually nice, and I've actually been excited to come out here and do this today. So I'm going to give you a little glimpse of where I walk so that you kind of have an idea of what I'm doing every day, and I'll see you guys tomorrow morning. So here's kind of where I walk. So what I do is I live over there, but I'm walking and I'm going to make a loop. So I'm going to walk here along the river. So that's the river right over there. And I'm going to be walking to this bridge that's maybe two and a half blocks from my house. So I'm going to walk down under this bridge, flip around, and then there's a whole nother loop that I'm going to take that goes completely back the other way, about a mile and a half. But look, it's beautiful out here. Only thing you got to watch for in these parts is animals. Hey guys, happy Tuesday, day two, and I am out and about. It is just a little after 5 a.m., like 5:05 or so, and I am on my typical walking route. So what I figured out yesterday is it takes me about 40 minutes to do my walk, so not bad at all. And I want to say that I just got under 4,000 steps doing my walk yesterday, so that's awesome. It's another beautiful morning, a little chilly, but yet again, walking will definitely warm me up. So day two, and I'm back at it. See you guys tomorrow. Hi guys, happy Wednesday. It is a little after 5, like 5:10 a.m., and I'm out doing my typical walk. And I just realized that I look exactly the same in all of these videos because I just throw on this blue t-shirt in the morning to go on my walk. So it's kind of interesting, but it's like 52 degrees, so I'm not really getting sweaty, so I can just kind of wear the same, you know, workout type of gear the whole week. So it's Wednesday and I'm back at it, day number three. So of course I'll be walking tomorrow, and that rounds out my 4 days that I wanted to start with this week. So woo, yay me. So anyway, I'm gonna enjoy my walk and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Good morning, happy Thursday. Day number four of going on my walks. It's a little after 5 a.m. I'm actually not working today. I'm going to a job fair, so I'm gonna take a little longer walk, just a little bit more of a stroll. Let me just tell you guys, I'm sore. Like, my calves and my leg muscles are sore. And I think it's just because I'm not used to this every day, you know, 4 days in a row walking. And I worked my tail off yesterday at work. I had almost 11,000 steps. So I just don't think that my body is really used to this quite yet. So anyways, I'm here. I'm walking. It's another beautiful morning, and I'm going to flip you guys around and show you again kind of what I see. I'm going a different way today. So let me flip you around and show you. So today I decided to walk this way, which is the opposite way that I normally walk, and go under the train tracks here, and it leads to a whole nother part of where I live. When you come out from under the tracks, you can see the river here. We actually live kind of kitty corner from the river, and then you've just got the rest of the walking area. So I'm just going to take this road, which is kind of in a wooded area, so it's going to be a beautiful walk.